Welcome to Selenium Master Test Automation Crash Course Selenium Python WebDriver Lesson 17 Python Database Test Section Update Test. In this lesson, I will teach you how to test update statement using Python PyMS SQL module in your Selenium Python WebDriver test automation framework. Now let's look at the database. On this AdventureWorks 2012 database, I have a table human resources dot department test. When I execute the SQL select script, select all from human resources dot department test, I will see all the records in this table. In some testing, you may need to update some of the test data in a table. So we need to execute update statement to update any record for a given condition. Let's say on this table, I have a name Selenium Master 222. I need to update this name to Selenium Master Python. We can use Python PyMS SQL module to trigger the update statement. And again, in order to update the table, the user should have update access on the table. In our script, we need to use the database server name, seleniummastertest.database.windows.net, and the database name, AdventureWorks 2012. And the user I'm using in the Python script already have update access to the human resources dot department test table. Now let's look at the script. I open the Selenium Python WebDriver project and created a folder database under the package com.seleniummaster.python. Under the folder database, I created a Python file update.py. On this Python file, I used Python unit test framework. So I use import unit test to import Python unit test module. Now I will be using PyMS SQL module. So I import PyMS SQL module. I defined a class Python database testes, and this class extends Python unit test dot test case module. On the setup method, I create a MS SQL connection. I defined a variable server underscore name equals the double quote Selenium master test dot database dot windows dot net. This is the server URL or server name. Then variable SQL underscore port equals 1433. Then username equals string double quote SM test user at Selenium master test. Then user underscore password equals string double quote password with capital P, number one, and exclamation symbol. Then database underscore name equals Adventure Works 2012. Now I created a connection variable self.con equals pymssql.connect server equals server name, user equals username, port equals SQL underscore port, password equals user underscore password, database equals database underscore name. So in this connection string, I need to use server name, username, database connection port, password, and database. Now I defined a test method, test underscore verify underscore record underscore update. Then con variable equals self.con. This variable is local to the test. Now I create a cursor for the update statement. So cursor underscore update equals con.cursor. So define a cursor which is for executing a SQL script. Now I defined SQL statement, SQL underscore statement. So this statement is for updating the table. Update human resources dot department test and set name equals percent s string argument where name equals percent s string argument. So we need to find name equals to the argument selenium master 222 and set the name to selenium master python. Now I defined arguments. So first argument selenium master python, this argument will be replaced with the first percent s symbol. The second argument selenium master 222 will be replaced with the second percent s symbol. Now cursor underscore update dot execute SQL statement and arguments. In order to simplify any SQL statement, you can use arguments. So you define one SQL statement and you define arguments like percent s for string value or percent d for numeric value. So this cursor underscore update dot execute will replace the arguments with the symbol percent s and execute the SQL script. Now con dot commit. Then I create a cursor for select statement because I need to verify that the change is in place. Or in other words, when I replace the name selenium master 222 with the name selenium master python, that record should exist. Now if you look at the database, we don't have selenium master python record in the name field. So define a cursor equals con.cursor. Now I defined a select statement. So select underscore statement equals select name from human resources dot department test where name equals percent s. So for percent s, I defined arguments. This will be second argument for the select statement. So I can just simply rename it argus. So we have already defined arguments in the previous line, so I don't want to confuse. Now cursor dot execute select statement and argus. Now print cursor dot fetch all, we print all records. Now record this equal cursor dot row count. Then print number of rows are. Record this. Now close the cursor. Cursor dot close. Then self dot assert true. Record this equal one. So we should have one record with the name Selenium Master Python. On the teardown method, I need to close the connection. So self.con.close. And on the main method, I just call unittest.main if I want to execute the script outside of the Python IDE. Now I right click on the update.py and choose run unit tests in update. So all tests passed, one test passed, and Selenium Master Python is the output. Number of rows are one. So the test is successful because the assertion is successful. Now let's verify that using the database console. So I open the SQL Server Management Studio and execute select all from human resources.department test and execute the SQL. Now we have Selenium Master Python. That means that Selenium Master 222 has been replaced with the name Selenium Master Python. So you can use Python PyMS SQL module to verify update statement. And on this lesson, you learned how to execute SQL script with arguments.